Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I attend sometime Ian Ramsey lecture in Oxford, and last time a well-known scientist came and delivered a lecture. But they are materials scientists, so they know the material of spirituality is altogether different, because God is spirit, is not material. So to understand God, you have to be a person of spirit, not men of letters. So here I am giving the miracles performed by Christ Jesus that the scientist can't explain. So in the context of all his miracles, it proves that our Father God dominates over the demiurge God of nature, Yahweh. Yahweh created male and female, and some were, you know, having legs, or lame, or could not see, but Christ Jesus then performed miracles and made them to see, which science can't explain. And in faith, we can move mountains that science cannot explain. Yahweh, the jealous and revengeful God of nature, created tempest, storm, to show his might when the boat in which Christ Jesus and his laborers were traveling started rolling. That frightened the only once-born laborer, Peter. Peter was the only once-born laborer, all the other were twice-born, who invoked Christ Jesus for help, as people do in churches, and their prayers are heard if they are part of the royal kingdom of God, in which God is worshipped. Not in the brick-built temples, the synagogues, but in the individual temples of God. In it should be God is to be worshipped, not by the works, you know, but in truth and spirit. Spirit is common sense. There are two spirits, spirit of man and spirit of God. Spirit of man is common sense. Peter was called the rock over which Christ Jesus proclaimed his temple would be built, not by human hands, but by the servient nature. So nature will build the temple, that's our physical body. That is, first seek the royal kingdom of God, then you have favors of our Father. The rest of the 11 virgin laborers knew that they are in the safe hands of their bridegroom, Christ Jesus. You remember the son who married the virgins? Parable of the marriage of the son. And the Christ Jesus is the bridegroom, and the others are virgin. And they were not troubled in their heart, such stopping the tempest of nature also clarified the doubts in the minds of his doubting laborers like Thomas and Judas Iscariot, that in Christ Jesus we dominate the nature too. That is why the least in the royal kingdom of God is greater than John the Baptist, an ideal priest of Moses, in which Yahweh is worshipped. So we are greater than that, means Yahweh is in our control. And this is very clearly stated in our Holy Book 6, that Shiva is seeking the sons of God for exposition and for learning. Thus, to overcome the troubled sea of life, Let Christ Jesus steer the boat of your life. Christ Jesus cannot take the helm of your boat unless you invite him into your heart or cleanse your heart of hypocrisy and become like the hearts of little children, unbiased and clear thinker. Like when Jesus prepared the new wine, he washed the old leaven out from the vats and put clear water. So that should be the heart of the person where if you want to brew the new wine within your heart. Remember that Christ Jesus is the life giver. And as a child, Christ Jesus made 12 sparrows of clay on Sabbath, a day devoted to God or philanthropy. And a rabbi saw him do that. He went to his foster father Joseph to make a complaint. And both of them came to Christ Jesus. Joseph was getting fed up, you know, everybody is complaining against Jesus, you know. So he was furious that he is upsetting rabbis and community. So he came to see Jesus. Christ Jesus put life into those sparrows and reminded them to keep him in their minds, because Christ Jesus is for our minds, and the birds of the air have very strong sensory organs. So their minds is awakened. So that's why Jesus said, you know, some seed fell on flat ground. Flat ground are like people who have no thinking power. They are once born, like the university professors. They have no thinking power. They only know what is written, but what is underneath, they can't know, they can't understand. So these are the seed fell on flat ground, and people like me go there and pick out the sense out of them. Birds of the air means sensible people. That miracle astonished the rabbi and Joseph, but the rabbi, full of the old wine of letters, did not appreciate what lesson has been given by Christ Jesus. That is why when Christ Jesus was preaching gospel in Jerusalem, hardly anyone recognized him to be the Christ. But as soon as he went to a Samaritan village, John 4, even their women recognized Christ Jesus to be a prophet. She wetted Christ Jesus in spirit, and even the laborers of Christ Jesus, they were astonished with the question and answers. She and her whole village became apostles. Samaritan woman was known by many names, representing light, and Fortuna is the most popular name. Photon, Fortuna, a ray of light. The Messianic Jews patched the rotten old cloth, the written Torah, with the brand new cloth, the gospel parables. Now, Christ Jesus forbade not to bring in the Jewish leaven. Remember how he prepared the new wine in Cana. He washed the old wine out of the vats. Vats is our physical bodies, and filled them with clean water. That means made them people to be like little children, clean water. And then they were turned into new wine. So people having the letters of the rotten old Torah, they cannot understand gospel. The patch became worst through corruptions, making the Bible worse than the present theologian have no idea who created Adam and Eve. So it became so, you know, that these people don't know who created Adam and Eve, because the two gods, Demiurge God Yahweh, is jealous and revengeful, and our Father is loving and merciful, just the opposite. So they are confused, you know, which God is which. And even university professors don't have any idea, you know, between the two, because they all go by letters. Letters made you drunk with the old wine, you desireth not the new. The blind guides, rabbis, became versed in these dog-collar hirelings in churches of Mammon to fulfill the saying Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, in which Jesus stressed the arid temple spirit, evil temple spirit, that means evil temple priest who were made redundant. You know, temple, that one is the wine press that did not produce good quality fruit. So Christ Jesus gave that parable, the last one over there. Then the master of the wine press, our Father, said, it's no good. Let me send my son. They were recognized him and treat him with reverence. But when he went there, they caught hold of him and killed him too. So that temple was destroyed by God. And they cannot rebuild it, because its replacement is in the Golden Temple in India, the holiest of holy. So they have been left with the Western Wall. West is the side of Satan. So today they are worshipping the Western Wall, which is worshipping Satan. And you can see how they put the prayers and all that. Prayers and other things does not make sense if you are hypocrite. So that is the temple. They enter in the temple priests, they enter into the church of God, they bring in their Torah. With Torah came the old customers back into the churches, and they created an atmosphere similar to Jerusalem, where nobody wanted to know Christ Jesus. So when the apostle used to go to such churches, they had no desire to know gospel parables. They were reading New Testament also by the letters, like the old. So, and making the present churches worse than the Jerusalem temple that was destroyed forever in 70 AD. As in Jesus, we have the fellowship of solitary virgin laborers. We are freemen and not these slave disciples of rabbis or pope. So, in the next video, I will explain the